actually went to the game with him before, and so I didn't give him my tickets away. And I mean, he was close. I mean, you know, he going in there and eating in the inside, you know, free food, and, you know, they drink and things like that. And, you know, you get all those things for free. And me and my wife was just mesmerized, like, wow, you know, we come all the time, but just didn't have this kind of view, you know. You know, you can see people, you know what I'm saying? You know, and you can hear the hits, you know. And so he asked me, he said, Lee, were you a season ticket holder? And I said, yeah. He said, where you sit at? And I said, man, I'm up, I don't even want to tell, you know. Well, I'm in the game, I'm in the ballpark, you know. I said, but I'm up there, you know. And he said, well, how much you pay for your ticket? I said, $1,500. He said, for one? I said, no, for both, for two. And he said, let me ask you a question. He said, you're paying $1,500 for the season, for the season tickets. And he said, but let me ask you a question. He said, you look down there, and he said, do you think that the conversation is going to be the same with the people who are paying $1,500 versus the ones that's down there paying $4,000 or $5,000? And I said, yeah, the conversation is going to be different. He said, how many people do you think can afford $1,500? A lot of people. You know, still a lot of money, but a lot of people. He said, how many people can afford $3,000 or $4,000 or $5,000 for season tickets? Probably not a whole lot of people. And if they can, they're probably not going to spend it. He said, and that's the point. He said, that's the point. He said, the conversation and the communication that's going to take place up there with $1,500 tickets is going to be totally different than the ones down there where they're paying $4,000 or $5,000. And I said, you're right. And I'm going to tell you something. The next season, I went and I spent some good money on some season tickets. And I've met some seriously important people.
Yes.
I ain't meet nobody up there with them $1,500 tickets. Nobody. You know what I mean? And guess what? And if the weather looked like it was going to rain, I might give it a ticket up. And I'm going to the one when it looked like it was going to rain for them $3,000 or $4,000. But it was different. Let me tell you something. Up there where I was at, you know, they wear jerseys or some shorts and different things like that. Down there, they're wearing slacks with, look like coaches. The shirts look like they, you know, they pay good money for them. And the conversations was different.
Yeah.
And I've met the owner of Simon Enterprises, which is the guy who does all of the website for like State Farm and SunTrust and all those people. And I've met Richard, which is the guy who franchised State Farm. You know, Aaron, which is another gentleman who's doing some real big business here in Jacksonville. And let me tell you something. When, you know, these people, if I would have just met them on the street, I probably would have felt that they was kind of funny acting. But when you start communicating with them, they're just some regular, you know, down-to-earth individuals. You know, but we get intimidated, you know, because of their position.
Yes.
You know, and so at that point, I begin to realize that it's just not good enough to just be in the house.
Right.
Because that was my mindset.
You was in the
I'm
park.
Here. I'm in the park. I'm seeing the same thing you're seeing. Mm-hmm. But I'm not getting the same thing that they were getting down there.
Amen.
That's the difference.
Yes.
What's the use of just being there if you're not there with a purpose in mind and getting something out of it?
Amen.
Your time is too valuable to come to church or to be places.
Amen.
Just to be there.
Yes.
You have to maximize your time.
Amen.
And your opportunity every day God wakes
Amen.
You up.
Yeah.
Look for a reason
yes.
to be a blessing or to become a blessing.
Amen.
Look for a reason. Find something good out of everything.
Yeah.
If you have purpose, you have passion, you have dreams, all you have to do is be in the right place at the right time.
Amen.
Don't think it's a coincidence when something happened. Run with it. And if the picture looks too big when somebody paint it before you, still run with it. Still try to walk into it. Statistics says 57 people who has an idea that does not do it, 48% of them become successful by other people.
Yes.
Doing the idea.
Doing the idea.
Yes. Wow.
So you have ideas and that can be manifested in your life, but because your finances look kind of funny and your change may seem kind of strange, you just don't find the right people to hook up with, the association to hook up with, to buy into the vision. But what happens is that we may not just have a clear vision. And if you don't have a clear vision and you don't know how to communicate it, then people will not move in front of the vision. So if you have a passion and you have a dream and you can communicate it, then that's going to give you the opportunity to get before the right people without a dime.
Without a dime.